Hello YouTube, what's going on? Welcome, this is your tech guy here. Today we're gonna discuss about the software development life cycle, and in this SDLC we're gonna talk about these seven basic steps you need to understand when it comes to SDLC. And the first step we're gonna talk about is planning phase. In the planning phase, you're gonna understand how your application is going to run, how it's going to be designed, how it's going to work, and the functionalities and stuff like that, right? The second phase we talk about is analysis, right? In analysis, this is where the developers, the product owners, the testers, the operations managers, and stuff like that come together. They discuss exactly what they want and how it's going to be working and what is going to be contained in their application, right? In this case, we're gonna define in detail what we had planned in our planning phase, right? For example, if we talked about registration, what is this registration going to do? After registration, maybe, for example, the username input field should be there. We should be having a submit button. We should be having a chat box for accepting terms and conditions. We should be having a password field for inputting the password. Then after that, we should be saving that user information in our database that we should be dedicated somewhere, right? Then after that, if it's in the login section, what is the user going to do after logging in? For example, after logging in, we should be having the username field for inputting the username, right? Then we should be having the password field, right? We should be having the submit button. After submitting that, the information of the user should be fed from the database, right? And then the username should be able to access the dashboard. Those are our rules, basically. The logout section, what is going to perform? We should be having a logout button. We should be having a clear session after logging out. It should be creating the session for someone else to log in, right? And then it should be preventing the account from being attacked by the, you know, like thieves and stuff like that, something we call account hacking and stuff like that, right? Cool. Then we can talk about the dashboard. Dashboard gonna be the main page, right? New users should be actually be redirected here. After creating an account, you should be redirected to the dashboard section, right? So the third phase is called design, right? In the design, we're gonna talk about the layout, we're gonna talk about the business rules, we're gonna talk about the color schemes, we're gonna talk about the programming languages. For example, in programming languages, we're gonna say, maybe I'm gonna use Ruby on Rails, we're gonna use Java, we're gonna use PHP, we're gonna use a different kind of technology stack and stuff like that, right? And the color scheme is gonna display the colors that you want your website to display. And business rules is gonna bring out the logic. How do you want this system to work? Maybe after logging in, it should clear sessions and stuff like that, right? The design pattern, you're gonna say, how is your system going to be responding? Is it responsive and stuff like that? That's what we talk about when it comes to design. And the last one before we proceed, we're gonna talk about the frameworks. Which kind of frameworks are you going to use in your design phase? Maybe you're going to use Java with Tomcat as a server, and then with maybe MySQL as a database right there. When you talk about maybe PHP, you're going to talk about PHP and Apache as a server, and then MySQL as a database right there. When you talk about JavaScript, you're going to say you're using JavaScript with Node.js and MongoDB as a database, right? Cool. So those are the kind of steps you're going to define when it comes to design, right? Then implementation phase, this is where you're going to set up the physical kind of hardware where the system is going to be projected or going to be built. Then number two, you're going to bring developers on board who are going to work on the project. Number three, you're going to say about designing of the UI, which is being to be done by the designers, right? Then the last one, it will be the testers who will be writing the unit tests to test your systems in every phase it's going through, right? Cool. The fifth phase is called testing phase. In the testing phase, we have testing phase, which is an important kind of step when it comes to SDLC. Why? Because this is where we're going to test our bugs. You test for bugs, you get the bugs are there, you put them in a bug tracking system, for example, like Jira, and then after that, you assign a given developer to work out to sort of fix those bugs so that the system will be working in a recommended way before pushing it to the deployment phase, right? It's called a bug life cycle. I think in the next one, I'm gonna do a video on bug life cycle. Oh my bad. Yeah, bug life cycle, cool. So the sixth phase is called the deployment phase. In the deployment phase, this is where now you're gonna do something called scalability. You're gonna check on staging, okay? You're gonna check on production. You're gonna set up the links and on the databases and then the URLs, deploying the application means pushing the application into the live server for it to be consumed by the, you know, entire world or users outside the environment, right? On the targeted audience, on the kind of perform what it was meant to be performing, right? Cool. The last phase, which is the seventh phase in this case, we're talking about the seventh phase, it's called maintenance. Maintenance is a very important part when it comes to SDLC. Why is it important? In the maintenance stage, we have the servers, you're maintaining the servers, you're maintaining the databases, you're doing a lot of testing every time, you're doing a lot of regression analysis, you're going to do a lot of your testing and stuff like that. You're fixing bugs and making sure that the system is working well. So in that, I've talked about the seven basic steps which you're going to use when doing SDLC as your method of implementation in developing a software kind of application, whereby we've talked about planning, we've talked about requirement analysis, we've talked about design, we've talked about implementation, we've talked about testing, we've talked about deployment, and we've talked about maintenance. So in that, if you like this video, right here, down here, you can do a like, then you can give us a thumbs up, then you can subscribe to my channel to get more of these videos. Tomorrow I'm gonna do some different sort of video about software engineering and stuff like that. Hope you guys like it. Once again, your tech guy right here from Karen. I'll see you next time. Yeah.